This one here I wrote, this one here has took me 48 years to have where I have. And when I was in my coma, I thought it was going home with me. The creator of all things is everywhere and everything. To I, he is the great shepherd chief. Sometimes in life, my path comes upon one of darkness. That's when the great shepherd chief throws me a rope. This rope's made out of love and kindness. And he pulls me on that path that it's all good. It's on this path that it's all good I roam. Sometimes along this path, my spirit's weak and I fall down. That's when the great shepherd chief comes to me, picks me up, dusts me off, lends me his staff to lean upon. It may be a very long time from now. It may be a very short time. But the great shepherd chief's going to come to me, take me in a valley that the buffalo still roam, and all the water safe to drink. It's in this valley that the great shepherd chief's going to reach into my heart, and all the pain and hurt of this lifetime will be gone. It's then that the great shepherd chief will call upon all my animal spirits. The hawk, the wolf, the bear, the badger, they shall become one. It's then that me and the great shepherd chief is going to walk across that great rainbow in the sky to the great medicine lodge and sit and smoke the peace pipe forever. My name's Little Hawk, man. My first rainbow gathering was 1971. And I've been doing this, I guess, that many years. And I do it writing that it is said that when the earth is weeping, the animals are dying. A tribe of all people who come and care, they'll be called the warriors of the rainbow. Another one I write around, the earth is your mother, she holds you. The sky is your father, he protects you. The rainbow is your sister, she loves you. The wind is your brother, he sings to you. Okay, ho, the earth is weeping. I come from a society called the Dog Soldiers. The most fierce warrior of Cheyenne Indian Nation was called the Dog Soldier. They went into battle, they staked their lance in the ground. They took a 40-foot piece of rawhide, tethered that right foot to their lance. They never withdrew. They either won or died at that spot. Crazy Horse rode in his only tribal council. He said, I, Crazy Horses, came for your dogs. Not your dogs that sleep in your master's lodges and tremble middle night, for your crazy dogs. For there's an enemy bear headed to our village to kill us. I, Crazy Horse, once crazy dogs were fighting. He rode out 500 most fierce Cheyenne warriors that ever existed, and he went and killed Custer. I wrote this one for a brother of mine named Bobcat. I got busted for illegal transportation of a dead body through 7 state lines, thrown in federal prison for it. AIM, the American Indian Movement, come and got me out of prison. This goes to my brother Bobcat. We were all put here as keepers of the earth, not to live on her, to live with her. She seems sad at now what we do. To think mankind once lived in a cave and roamed as the wolf. I was walking in the woods today. I walked into a bobcat. But this bobcat could talk. He told me God had changed since he had came to the earth. I said he had not. Said yes, God had changed, for now mankind carried their God in their pocket. I said they did not. He reached into my pocket and pulled out my money. Said, see, I told you mankind now carried his God in his pocket. He dared to say I was killing the earth. I dared to say what I could do. Said one human being could do so much if they would only try. But he seemed to think I would not try. Because what could he expect from a two-legged animal who now carried his God in his pocket? Yeehaw! Hey, hippie chick, did anybody tell you that I ran a little green man eating a peyote button? He tried to tell me what a hippie was. He spelled hippie H-I-P-P-I-E. Then he tried to tell me that was a happy, intelligent person pursuing infinite enlightenment, but he couldn't spell all that dumb shit.